It's episode 3-0, and that is exactly what we're looking for. 3 wins and no defeats. Welcome back, guys, to Sur of Scotland 90. It is the FIFA 23 Heart of Midlothian career mode, and we have turned things around. After a pretty disastrous start to the season, we switched formation, we went back to the 5-2-3, and it's working. It has dragged us now all the way up to fourth. And after our opening 6 games, we had 1 win and 5 defeats. I just wish we never experimented. I wish we never tried a new formation, because I honestly believe we would be on the tails of Celtic and Rangers. I'm still going for the title. I think we can do it. We're only 16 points behind Celtic, and I know it seems a lot. We're 1 game away from the halfway point. But the reason I think we can do it is we played Rangers twice. We beat Rangers twice. We've proven that we can beat the big teams. We played Hibernian twice. We beat Hibernian twice. So we can win the derbies. And now we're beginning to win the smaller games as well. I'm just convinced that we can go on a good run. And what really, really got me thinking that we can turn this around and that we can finish the season super strong is last time out, we were playing St Mirren. We're trying to make a record. We're trying to win 6 games in a row for the first time. Now, we didn't beat St Mirren. We actually lost 3-2. However, we responded late in the Livy game to go ahead and win that 4-3. Normally in the past, once we lose after a winning streak, we would just fall apart. We would bottle it and we would go on a losing streak. But we didn't do that. We bounced straight back with a win. And that gives me confidence. So I've got a lot of confidence today going into this Ross County game. They are last. You know, they're joint last with St Johnstone and Livy, but last all the same. And I'm hoping that we can pick up 9 points today. I mean, if you look at who we're playing Ross County, then we're playing Dundee United, who's in 9th, and then we're playing St Johnstone, who is in 11th, joint last with Ross County. So we're playing 3 out of the 4 bottom teams. Anything but 9 points here would be an absolute disaster. We also have the Old Firm teams playing each other. Then we have Rangers against Hibs, Celtic against Aberdeen, Rangers away to St Johnstone, and Celtic against Motherwell. Look, the Old Firm, one of them is guaranteed to drop points over the next 3 games, but based on the fixtures they've got, I think you could see them dropping points elsewhere. So I know it's a big gap, but if we can take 9 points, I think we can close the gap to both of them in this episode. I think Celtic and Rangers will both drop points. That's my prediction, but it doesn't matter unless we get 3 wins out of 3. So let's start up next with Ross County. So again, we're going with an unchanged lineup. Why would you change what is working for us? It's going to be Gordon, Cochrane, Kingsley, Sibbick, Rolls, Atkins, and Benjamin, Devlin, Mackay, Shankland, and Ginelli. Ross County, I'm not going to lie, even though they're always last, even though they always suck, they do seem to cause us problems. So, I mean, I'm confident because we're playing well, but at the same time, we always seem to concede a goal to someone called Samuel, and Danda normally has an impressive game against us as well. And don't remember Jordi Helua up front. He is a Hearts legend for us in a Football Manager save. I believe it was 2022 last year. I think he was an absolute gem for us. So I've got a lot of respect for Jordi Helua, but I'll have no respect for him over the next 90 minutes. Early corner for Ross County. Snow's coming down here. Conditions are not great. That one is just over the bar. Craig Gordon diving, trying to get something on it, but it was over. It wasn't on target, and it looks like we're going to try and get this one restart it relatively quickly here, but I don't like these conditions, and I feel like they will definitely favour Ross County. I mean, we like to play good football, and it's going to be difficult to play good football with a pitch like this. Shankland, what a ball. What a fantastic ball. Picks out Ginelli. Josh Ginelli looking to come into a more central possession, but then he loses it. Not great there for Ginelli, and Danda's making a run, but he's offside. However, Kingsley was there. He read it anyway, so doesn't lead to anything. Stephen Kingsley now wall playing Alex Cochrane. Cochrane to Mackay. Mackay to Cammy Devlin. Devlin spinning around down. Cochrane again. Alex Cochrane. Alex Cochrane busting through. Good for Cochrane, but gets out-muscled and can't get his cross in. Disappointing in the end. 10 minutes into the game here. Dingwall, and it's still 0-0. Good header for Kingsley, just comes out of nowhere. Jumps above everyone, takes it. Shankland trying to hold it up. Gets tackled from behind, loses possession. And now Callaghan to Danda. Samuel again here. Jordi Helua. Oh no, that's a mistake. Jordi Helua. We've got players all over the place, and Jordi Helua hits the post. It's an unbelievable miss. He'd done all the hard work, and then he had the easy part to put it in, essentially, and he couldn't do it. I mean, I think Craig Gordon did a good job to come in and put him off, but Helua should score that 100%. And now Shanklin's going to try and get away past Ivor Cotty here, but Cotty plays it back to Laidlaw. And Ross County here will look to survive. Laidlaw launches it up. Atkins is going to try and get to this. He does. Plays in Benenjamy. Benenjamy heads it down. Cammy Devlin. Devlin then up towards Cochrane. All over the back of Cochrane. Civic comes though. Power header. Wins it out to Mackay. Mackay in towards Cochrane. Cochrane still with the ball. Cochrane looking for Benenjamy. Benenjamy lays it off. Josh Ginnelly strikes home and blocked. And it's still about to become the Ross County penalty box, but it's not going to lead to anything. County will clear. Good ball to Mackay. Mackay. Cochrane very advanced in this game. He must want a goal. It's Mackay to Shanklin. To Devlin. Devlin! His shot blocked. Well, it must have been blocked by Shanklin. It must have came off Shanklin because it's going to be a goal kick here. Devlin does well to win that. Ginnelly. Ginnelly now to Mackay. Mackay. Back to Kingsley. Kingsley to Mackay. Now it is Cochrane. Oh, nice for Cochrane. Cochrane looking for Benenjamy. Plays it into him. Benenjamy now. Central gives it away. Poor from Benny Benenjamy. But he does well. He wins it back. Ginnelly then. First to it. Devlin. Out to Atkinson. Finds Shankland. Lawrence. To Ginnelly. Ginnelly will run on to this. He's left it a little bit late. Ginnelly flicks the ball up. He's still trying to do something here. Now it's Ginnelly. Going to try and pick out Barry Mackay back post. And Mackay flicks that on. It's going to fall for Cochrane, who will keep it in. Mackay. Offside. I mean, I liked what we were going for there, but a mile offside. Oh, no. Kingsley puts in a tackle. He falls. Danda. Cochrane slides in. Craig Gordon comes out. Somebody gets on that. It's chipped. Oh, and it's wide. I can't believe it. Ross County must have thought they were going to score. It was a clusterfuck for us in the box, but we do get ready, and it's a big ball played up to Mackay. Mackay then will lay it to Cochrane, Cochrane to Devlin, and Devlin's going to try and pick out Shanklin. It's a decent ball, and Shanklin almost getting past the defender, but again, Ross County cutting that one out the back, and like I said, it's difficult to play in this game. Civic now has to chase Samuel, and I just don't like these conditions, and I tell you what, I like that defending even less, but Civic gets it, keeps it in. Now it's Craig Gordon. Gordon going to look for Ginnelly. It's found Ginnelly. It's towards Cammy D. Now it's Atkinson. Out to Ginnelly. Ginnelly now looking dangerous, trying to get away from Purrington. Ginnelly looking for a back post cross. It's towards Barry Mackay. It's away from Barry Mackay now. Benenjamy trying to head it down. Benenjamy's been caught there. And Benenjamy slides in, wins it. But again, there's no Hearts player coming in to help him. And we've got a Ross County player down. And I don't know if we're going to stop play or not. We're going to get to half-time. Hopefully he's all right. Hopefully there was no harm done. Rangers are currently drawn with St Johnstone. I did say I think both Old Firm teams will drop points. And at the moment, they are dropping points. But so are we. So we need to find something, guys, in this second half. We need to do something that's going to get us ahead. And I do think we're going to struggle in these conditions. We've just not been able to play that good today. And I'm hoping that we just get the win now. I mean, I'm not even thinking about comfortably beating Ross County or increasing the goal difference. It's all about the 3 points. It's Atkinson. Nice. Cammy Devlin! Oh, saved. One-handed save. Good save by the keeper, Benenjamy. Gets it to Mackay. Mackay back to Benenjamy. Benenjamy now. Finds Devlin. Devlin. Shanklin. Benenjamy. Barry Mackay. Mackay in towards. Oh, I don't. Who's that in towards? Seriously. It's fucking garbage. Civic needs to get that. He's not, but he's put Hulu off enough, or has he? Oh, Civic trying to fit. Oh, what the fuck is that? Great, I tell you what it is. It's a great save of Craig Gordon, but the defending there. The defending, wow, we don't want to see that again. How many opportunities did we have to get rid of that to win the ball? We just could not do it. Really, really poor defending. And we need to do better than that going forward. Benenjamy steps in, wins that. Good stuff, right? Come on. Now it's Ginnelly. Oh, he's trying to play it to Atkinson, and Atkinson's not even read that. Very, very poor there. Good tackle. Nicely timed tackle. Okay, Ginnelly now. Come on, Josh Ginnelly. Looking for Shanklin. Over the top. Ginelli running onto it. Ginelli's going to try and get past his man. He does. He's done okay here. Josh Ginelli still. Ginelli. Ginelli drills one. It's blocked. It's going to fall from again. Getting a bit lucky here. Benjamin. Devlin. Still Devlin. Out to Cochrane. Cochrane to Barry Mackay. Mackay back to Cochrane. Good stuff. Devlin! Oh, saved again by the goalkeeper. Puts it out for the corner. Barry Mackay delivery here. Looks decent. Shankland jumped for it. Ross County will clear their lines, but only as far as Cammy Devlin again. It is Josh Ginelli. Drills one low and it's blocked. And just no way through for us at the moment. We're huffing and puffing. But unlike the big bad wolf, we can't blow shit down at the moment. The only thing blowing is the ball here in these terrible conditions. 60 minutes gone, an hour gone, half an hour to go. And you feel like it could be one goal that wins it. I feel like this could be 1-0, but to who? I mean, I feel like it could also be 0-0. Although, having said that, oh, Sibic almost gets it. Sibic. Oh, no. Oh, this time Sibic does get it after multiple attempts. And now Shankland trying to lay it off to Barry Mackay, and it's poor. It's poor. Devlin trying to win that. Kingsley. Kingsley finally gets back in. I mean, we're having to work hard here. We're really having... Ross County are going for it. They need every point. They are desperate to avoid relegation. And now, here we go. Benjamin. Shanks. Out to Atkinson. Ginelli now played through, but again, he's just... The ball ain't great, and he's just not got the pace here. It's back to the goalkeeper. And we really need... Well, it's trying to give us a helping hand here. The goalie is taking a bit of a risk there, to be fair, but, you know, he made it work. Benjamin sliding in, doesn't win that. Now it's it to Watson. Watson now driving forward, plays it back to Purrington. Purrington. Kai Rolls here looking for a trying to one attack on Jordi Halua, but I mean, Ross County are doing a pretty good job now of holding on to the ball here. It's a good tackle, Atkinson. Now trying to drive us forward with 18 minutes left on the clock. Shankland to Benjamin. Benjamin. Oh, and again, we've just not been able to time the run. Very, very disappointing there. Again, Ross County coming forward. They're going for it. We're going for it. Everyone's going for it here. We know that this is a massive game. And we have to win it. A good tackle there. Let's go. Sibic again. Out to Cochrane. Cochrane to Shankland. Over the top. Cochrane continues the run. Cochrane's onside here. Alex Cochrane. No, I saved the game by the goalie. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Right, we're going to make subs. We're going to make subs. Right, here we go. Forrest, Humphreys, Grant, Keogh coming on. Cochrane, Shankland, Benjamin going off. We need this to be good. Come on, Barry Mackay, delivery. Onto somebody's head. Kingsley was there, doesn't get to it. And Ross County will look to play it from the back. Bit risky, but they've got away with it. They've managed to work that pretty well there. Keogh wins in, steps in. Good stuff. Right, come on. Ginelli, out to Keogh, to Grant, George Grant, still George Grant, lays it off to Keogh, Humphreys, Ginelli, finds Cammy Devlin. We're on the edge of the box here looking for something to happen. It's Alan Forrest. He tries to get the shot off and he's just too slow there. If you snooze, you lose, and we definitely lost it on that attack. Came to an end when really something better should have been on the receiving end of that build-up, and now Ross County might put something on the receiving end of their build-up. Oh, crucial block. And it's going to bounce it for a Ross County throw, and I believe it will. Cool. Oh, that's a quality. No way. I think, is he offside? He must be offside because we won the ball there. He is offside. I mean, we 100% won that. I honestly cannot believe I thought he gave a penalty. I really did, right? Keogh, come on. Keogh to Rolls. It's Kai Rolls. Humphreys. Rolls. Out to Ginelli. Josh Ginelli now. Kai Rolls. Rolls! Blocked. Ginelli needs to chase it now. Ginelli. And Ginelli now gets caught offside. Ah, oh, man. Both teams sharing offsides here. And I tell you what, with time running out, it could be one last opportunity, one last chance, wins this game, and, ah, oh man, it could fall for Ross County. It really could fall to Ross County here. Oh no! Offside! It's not! I don't believe it! It's White! White has scored! And I think White's won it for Ross County. I said one goal could win it. I wasn't wrong. Ah, and White's beating us. I don't know if it's the player that's beating us or if it's the snow that's beating us, but White has definitely beaten us today. The Ross County fans have never seen a win in their life, so obviously they celebrate that, but... Oh man, 89th minute to concede that. I mean, I don't think Craig Gordon should split that in. It's near post. I really don't. But yeah, it's not looking likely that we're going to get anything out of this, guys. Jordan White could be the difference maker today. Is there any chance here? Come on. Come on. Come on, Poddington with the ball. That's it. It's all over, guys. Unbelievable. Again, I did say at the start of the game, I said we always struggle against Ross County. And we have struggled today. We just didn't turn up. I knew it from the kickoff. And Celtic ended up drawing. Look at that. The league leaders drew. Oh, man. So we could have caught up on them. We haven't done that. And we've bottled it, guys. We've absolutely bottled it. And we dropped down to sixth place. Celtic now actually dropped down to second as well. And now we find ourselves 18 points off the Rangers. Wasn't that long ago. We were only, 12 behind Rangers. Now, obviously, we've lost a couple of games. And Rangers are on a winning run. So, yeah, we just need to bounce back, guys, against Dundee United. Simple as that. All right, here we go then. Ross County have beaten us. Hopefully, we do not suffer the same fate against Dundee United. We're lining a couple of changes for today. Kieran Mortensoglu coming in and Forrest and Humphreys. So we just had to change things around a little bit for fitness. Dundee United are lining up basically with the same formation as us. So hopefully we don't cancel each other out. Looks like we're going to get rain again today, which is disappointing. We seem to be at our best when the conditions are dry and sunny and we just get a good pitch. But yeah, we're not going to use that as an excuse, guys. Let's bounce back. Look, I said I wanted 9 points at the start of this episode. If we can salvage six, then fair enough. But we cannot afford to drop anymore. Let's go. Ginelli picks out Benjamin. Chests it down. Follies it. Blocked. And already there a couple minutes in, I thought we were looking at a wonder goal, but didn't quite happen. Shahoum now out to Niskanen. And Niskanen's away. And Niskanen's got the pace. Oh, and he's run out. He's run out for a goal kick there. Niskanen too quick for his own good. Let's get this started quickly. Here we go. Picks it out to Benjamin. Benjamin now. We'll look for Humphreys. Humphreys. Oh, Humphreys. I think left one in there. I tell you what, he's lost. I think we won the ball, but it was a nasty tackle. It was like fishes there. It really was. Hard hitting. Got the ball back, though. Come on. Let's go. Kieran Mortensoglu. He's still down. Kieran Mortensoglu is going on his own. Plays. Oh, Humphreys. Why did we stop? Oh, man. I didn't think we were going to get through. I turned round. I stopped. And, wow, we've just basically gifted Dundee United the ball there. What a chance that would have been for Humphreys had we kept running. We didn't do it. And now we need to try and win the ball back. Freeman is going to... Oh, Freeman goes past Cochrane. It's a chance here. Oh, it's away. It's Niskanen. Kai Rolls. Finally, we get ready at Sivic now. Sivic's going to bomb forward. And he's just took a heavy touch there. And that's really poor. God damn it, man. We're not playing that good this episode. We're really not. And it's through to Tony Watt. And it's all over. Tony Watt scored. 13th minute. Unlucky for us. I said we weren't going to fall apart. Maybe I should retract that statement, guys, because we're losing again now. And it's Dundee United with the lead. At least we've got time to come back for this, but hardly the ideal situation. And yeah, we find ourselves trailing here against Dundee United. It's going to be tough work, guys. We haven't started well. Dundee United have been pretty good, and they've punished us with that one chance. Tony Watt knows where the back of the net is, and he has taken it on this occasion. So yeah, still lots of time to go, but we're going to need to improve big time. Ginelli. Josh Ginelli. Oh, no, blocked him. I mean, it was good defending for Dundee United. I kind of thought Josh Ginelli was going to go all the way there, but it wasn't to be. I got a little bit hopeful, but in the end, Dundee United seen us out. Oh, Kai Rolls makes a good tackle there. And the referee's pulled that back. That's ridiculous. Gave us a yellow card as well for that. I mean, we clearly won the ball. Cannot believe we were booked for that tackle. But here we go. Ginelli to Forrest. Forrest then over the top to Ginelli. Brilliant ball. Ginelli takes it down. Ginelli trying to chip the keeper. It's top netting. Robbie Nielsen's no happy. I'm no happy. Nobody's happy with that one. Ginelli really should have scored. Brugetti came out, put us under pressure. He kind of tricked us into taking on the chip, and it certainly did not work. And look at Nielsen there. Furious on the sidelines. It's Forrest. Kier Mortisoglu. Out to Cochrane. Cochrane gets a ball in. Brilliant! Fantastic! I tell you what, that is the cross of the season. Alex Cochrane has delivered an absolute belter of a cross, and it lands in the perfect position for Stephen Humphreys, who heads it home. You will not see better than that. The Hearts fans celebrating. We've got the equaliser. We begin to panic, begin to think it would not be our day, but yeah, I was wrong. Cochrane was right. It's 1-1. Oh, another cross in, and it's cracked the crossbar this time. Right, we're going to bring on Barry McKay. Alan Forrest appears to have an injury, but god damn it, those crosses from the left-hand side proven to be dangerous. McKay, again with the ball. McKay, still McKay going left foot. It hits it, good strike, but unfortunately straight at Brugetti. Barry McKay, again cutting inside. McKay! Oh my god, I mean his shots are getting worse. And Robbie Nielsen's patience is wearing out, man. McKay, what is he doing? How can he get that one so wrong? May actually took a deflection. No, it didn't. Just a terrible shot. McKay again. Oh, Barry McKay gets past! Another shot just drizzles over the bar, but Barry McKay looking very, very dangerous since he came on here. And it is 1-1 at the break, but I think we're on top. I think we're looking more likely to win this game. Let's hope that is true. Celtic currently drawn against Aberdeen, so Celtic beginning to falter a lot. Rangers are beating Hibs, so we really need to win here to try and keep the pressure on them. But yeah, Celtic definitely out of the two Old Firm sides. They look like the team that we'd be more likely to catch, because their results haven't been great lately. But you know, we need to get back to that big winning run. 5 wins in a row, that's what we need. We need to start doing that more often than not. So yeah, let's see if we can snatch a winner here, second half, and get back with a big green W. Cochrane to McKay. McKay does well. Looks, comes into a central position. Takes a shot. Block. Ginelli. In towards Barry McKay. Oh, and he misconnects with his. It looked like a, I don't know, a pump kick or something, man. It wasn't very good, though. And that one has went wide. Or into the goalkeeper's hands, should I say. Ball in back post. Headed away again. Another chance, we just could not get anybody on the end of that one, and it looks like that free kick has been given. Advantage played here. Ball it to McCann. Niskanen. Up the top. Humphreys, McKay. Heavy touch, and we just, oh man, we are running out of time here. It's getting close to the end of this game, and we still are level. We need to find a winner. And I'm beginning to panic. Oh no, speaking of panicking, we could be in trouble here. Sibic needs to get back. Sibic's not got back. Craig Gordon though comes out, does well, gathers it, rolls it to Ginelli, to Benenjamy. Benenjamy's not got to it though. Middleton now. Cochrane. Right, Kingsley, come on, let's go. Let's get forward. Humphreys lays it off. Kieran Mortisoglu, you're going to look for. I don't know, I mean, that's terrible. Oh, it's not terrible. Humphreys can get to this. Humphreys, can he score? Can he get the rebound? Oh, he's put the side netting, man. Stephen Humphreys, what has he done? What has he done? We're going to bring on Carrion Keogh here. Oh, man. What a chance. Gone, Stephen Humphreys. An opportunity to possibly win it for us. And he's missed both of them. Cochrane wins that, right. Come on. Barry McKay again, this time to Humphreys. Humphreys out towards Cochrane. Cochrane. Cochrane left foot it in. Kuehl's there. Kuehl heads it down. Humphreys! Oh, what is Humphreys doing? What? I'm taking him off. What? Why is Humphreys being so shit? Why can't he hit the target? Why can't he score? I mean, you're not going to get many better chances than that, and he just is unable to take any of them. All right, Snodgrass, Shankland, and Boyce coming on, guys. We're pushing for it. And with 9 minutes to go, we need to push as hard as we possibly can if we are going to come away with the victory. Kai Rolls heads it down. Kier Mortisoglu now has it. McKay. Lauren Shankland. Lauren Shankland again hits it, and it's, I mean, it's too easy for Brugetti. We need to do better than that. But I tell you what, Kuehl's picked it up. This is a chance now. Shankland. Oh, through to Carrion Kuehl. Hercule in towards no one. Header. Bakai. No, it's out of the way. Snodgrass win that. He can't. And Dundee United will get rid of it again. Dundee United now trying to play it for the back. We're trying to win it. Time's running out here. A lot of time's running out. We need to win that. Oh no, we could be in a bit of trouble. Counter attack could be on. Counter attack could be on here. And now it's it to Middleton. Oh, Cochrane though will step across him. And now it's another chance here for Hearts to bomb forward. Well, not with a pass like that, it's not. Keo Mortisoglu. That is fucking horrendous. Kai Roll steps in, wins it. Come on, let's go. Not a lot of time left here. This could be the last attack. Boyce steps out, steps back, but we have to get forward here. We ain't got time to go back the way. We literally probably have to score for this attack. This balls it to Barry Mackay. Barry Mackay now is going to try and wait for it. Barry Mackay on it straight into the hands of the goalkeeper, guys. And it's another game where we drop points. It's just not good enough. It's not good enough. It's 1 point against Dundee United. What a run. You know, we had a great chance to come up against teams in the bottom four. And we're quickly blowing this. I mean, statistics-wise, 16 shots to 3. We should have won that based on statistics. But I don't think we created good enough chances, if I'm being honest, guys. Well, actually, saying that, Humphreys did miss a shitload. So, maybe. I think we should blame Humphreys for that one. But regardless, yeah, Celtic ended up winning. Rangers won. Maybe we need to just accept that the old firm is getting too far ahead of us now, guys. So, I don't know. I do not know, but, yeah, we've began to bottle it. We need to end on a high. We need to win the last game. We can't afford to let this run continue anymore. And what's this? What is this? Who's coming through the door? It's Lukas Podolski. What is Podolski doing? He's already at the club. Is he back for injury? Is Lukas Podolski returned from injury? I'm not too sure why he's doing all this training. I mean, you've already been at the club. But he's going to hold up the shirt. Now he's wearing it. And, well, it is nice to see Lukas Podolski in a Hearts shirt again, I'm not going to lie. Ben O'Neill's been loaned it for 2 years. We'll see if he can become a better player. But, yeah, guys, up next, St Johnstone, another game at home for us. And it is a must-win matchup, I believe. We're playing last place, St Johnstone, so we better win it. Let's put it that way. All right, this is it then. Come on, let's do it. Let's finish this episode. I wouldn't say in style, but let's try and redeem something. We're taking on St Johnstone. We are getting Shankland in there, thankfully. Humphreys, I don't think we'll play a game for a while after that last performance. It's going to be Gordon, Cochrane, Kingsley, Sibbick, Rolls, Axon, Halliday, Devlin, Mackay, Ginelli, and of course Lawrence Shankland up front. Atkinson now, come on, in towards Halliday again. Andy Halliday, oh, he's trying to find Ginelli, gets it back though. Andy Halliday sliding in, wins it again. Ginelli on the right hand side, looking for a cross in. Barry Mackay's there, Devlin's here, chests it down well, strikes it, blocks it. Come on, Ginelli back in towards Devlin. Devlin's trying to get it back in towards the box, and we end up losing the ball again. And now St Johnstone on the counter. Witherspoon through to Rodden, and we could be in a bit of danger. Yeah, we are. I do not believe it, guys. What the fuck is happening to us? Why are we so shit? Rodden with the goal, and man, after that great run, you know, after that great winning streak of 5 games in a row, we're beginning to fucking fall off the edge of a cliff again. I don't know why we continue to do this to ourselves. Right, yeah, this game's still long. We can still come back, but just it's not a great start. It's not what you're wanting. And already we feel like we're chasing the game. Ball through to Atkinson. He tries to get it. Swipes at it, but just didn't really connect. Ryan McGowan. Good interception. Come on, Devlin. Halliday. Atkinson. Ginelli. Halliday. And Halliday loses it. Andy, what are you doing, son? Now it's out to Bloxham. Kai Rolls is trying to chase him back. He's got something on that. And I tell you what, that's a crucial sliding tackle for Kai Rolls. He got enough on it to prevent the goal there, 100%. And now it is Barry Mackay out towards Ginelli. Ginelli will bring this one down. Still Ginelli looking for cross. It's dangerous into towards the back post. But Wills is there and Wills brings it in and collects it. Shanks. Oh, another save by Wills. The shot, though, I mean, it was a pretty poor shot, in fairness. I think Wills has made a little meal out of that save. I think he could have made it a lot easier than that, but now it's getting away from him. Witherspoon, good tackle. Now it's Atkinson. Andy Halliday finds Lauren Shankland, and again, that's not good enough. We lose out. Right, Halliday again this time, come on. Andy Halliday. Halliday. Cammy Devlin. Oh, shot blocked. And again, it just falls perfectly for St. Johnstone. We're not having a lot of luck here. Approaching half time, but well, we need to find something because at the moment we haven't really got much. And it's showing here in terms of scoreline. I don't know why, but the last like 3-4 games, ever since we really. I know we beat Livingston, but it was still a struggle at 4-3. I feel like ever since we lost to St. Mirren, ever since our winning run came to an end, we have struggled and we need to fix it. And that's a big save to Craig Gordon. Makes a huge save. Last thing we could afford there was to go 2-0 down before the break. We're going to have to try and win that. We do win it. It's back in. Kai Rolls is there. Oh, no. Oh, yes. It's 2-0. And all of a sudden, guys, this win is getting away from us. And that defending is fucking abysmal. Who's number 19? Atkinson. With some of the worst defending. No, it's not Atkinson. Who is number 19? Who the fuck is that? Why can I not remember who number 19 is? Who is not? Wait, do we even have a number 19? Who fucking is number 19? Wait, it's not Cochrane. Oh, it is Cochrane. Well, Cochrane screwed us there big time. I'm blaming him. The defending was pish. And it is 2-0, guys, at the break. Massive second half needed here. Are we going to step up? Are we going to turn it around? Or are we going to fall apart and drop it to top six? The next 45 minutes will give us that answer. Alright then, second half beginning. We brought on Boyce, we brought on Oda. We're just going for it. We're putting a lot of players forward here. And we're going to try and take this game to St. Johnstone at the earliest stage possible. Oda now with the ball. Back to Cammy Devlin. Now it is Boyce. Liam Boyce. Finds Oda. Oda then lays it off to Barry Mackay. Mackay back. Devlin. Oh, and that's poor, man. Very poor. Oda. Oda. Shankland! Oh my god, that's a terrible shot for Shankland. That was going so wide there. I don't know what we're doing. Good tackle for Sibic. Oda again now. Oda trying to run out wide, and again we've just ran into danger. It's not worked out for us. Sibic comes across. Wins another good tackle. Now it's Devlin. Out to Oda. Oda. Oda looking for Boyce. Or looking for, I don't know who that is. We didn't find it. Whoever it was, we needed to try and get him. And we did not. And now St. Johnstone are bombing forward. But we track back. We win that. Right, let's go. Come on. Let's go. Shanks. Devlin. Again, ball it to Oda. Again, Oda. Oh, man. He just... His end product just isn't really there. Oda. Through to Boyce. That's a good goal. Come on, good pass to Boyce. Good goal for Boyce. And now we give ourselves a chance. 62 minutes on the clock. Boyce fires us back into the game. But the job is far from done, guys. We need to bounce back. We need more. And we need to get another 2 goals. But Liam Boyce gets us right back in it. Ball out to Devlin again, come on. I mean, it's Ginelli even. Ginelli looking for Mackay off the crossbar. Oda trying to head it in. Going to be picked up by Devlin. Barry Mackay. Halliday. Boyce. Still Boyce. Cammy Devlin. Drills one. Puts it wide. Chance gone. We're going to bring on George Grant here. Sibic. Ah, Sibic there just running into danger. Running into the St. Johnstone player. I tell you what, we could be running into trouble, and I think we're running out of time. This looks threatening. Craig Gordon comes out, gets a good save in. Had to get a good save. Now it's up to Ginelli. Let's go. Well, what a great save that was to keep them in this. Ah, no. Poor. As they certainly haven't been at their best today.
Well, it was a splendid piece of goalkeeping, but he has to run.
Sivic comes across trying to win that. Instead, he gives away the corner. We are running out of time. Big time. St Johnston taking this short. And you feel like when they take it short. Yeah, you feel like when they take it short, guys, we are running out of time. We're going to bring on Carrion Cole now. 13 minutes to go, but we could be looking at another defeat here, which would obviously be a disaster. Well, Kingsley heads away. Come on, boys. Get that down. It's not good enough. It's... Kai Rolls keeps it in. Come on. Kai Rolls up towards Ginelli. Ginelli to Liam Boyce. Can we play him back? Can we find Liam? Can we Ginelli get the ball? He can. He's going to go onto that. Surely he's going to go onto that. Ginelli cuts back. Boyce. Boyce now. Oda. Kuhl. Drillies it. Oh, saved by the goalie again. All right, we're going to bring on Benny Benenjamin here. 9 minutes to go. Who can take this? I don't think Carrion Cole's going to be the man to take it. It's going to be Stephen Kingsley. Delivery here needs to be good. It's decent, to be honest. Shankland's there. It's going to fall for Grant, and he's going to lose it. Absolute garbage for Grant, but Ginelli steps up. Ginelli helps win it back. Shanks. Grant. Benenjamin drills one. Saved again by the goalkeeper. Wow, we just cannot seem to get a goal here. Come on. Again, it could be Grant this time, I think, to come over and take this one. George Grant now, but another ball, and this one looks good. It's headed away again, though. Ginelli. Ginelli drills it. See, blocked again. Grant, come on. Benenjamin. Boyce. Oh, shot blocked. Oda. Something's happened here. Can we win this? We need to win that. We haven't won it, and now St Johnston really could be about to put us in pressure, but we win it back. Come on, Boyce. Benenjamin. Ah, Benenjamin can't find Boyce in that. That's probably it. I think the win's gone now. I don't think there's enough time for us to get the ball back and score two goals. Kingsley steps up, wins it. What the fuck is that? What is that for Kai Rolls? Unbelievable there. He's Kai Rolls has cost us a chance big time. 2 minutes added on here. I mean, I think the win is gone. We need to just try and rescue a point. Shanks. Oda. Oda loses it. St Johnston will surely win the game now. And they have. I don't believe it, guys. I actually do not believe that. I'm fucking gutted. I am gutted. I don't want to look at stats. I don't want to look at shit. I know we were the better side. I know we created more opportunities, but I don't want to see it. I do not care. I just want to get that over and done with. I'm fucking raging. Oh, man. Why have we bottled it? Why the fuck have we bottled it? Up next, Scottish Cup. But right now, I want to forfeit the cup. I want to forfeit everything. Now we're down into seventh. And, you know, we got the gap to the Old Firm right down. And now Celtic have a 22-point lead over us. How's that happened? I do not know. What I do know is, so our form has went to complete and utter mincemeat. I don't know why. We were on the verge of greatness. We were on the verge of getting six in a row against St Mirren. But since we lost that game, look at the stats. Look at the last five games. 4 points out of 15. Unacceptable. Unacceptable, guys. Now I'll be looking to bounce back straight away. Double header next against Celtic. League and Cup. Look, that's what I'm focusing on right now. I've got nothing else to say. We've been really, really poor the last five games. I'll be looking to bounce back in the Cup. Simple as that again. I apologise, guys. I mean, we're not going to win the league this season. I can accept it. It was looking good. Up until that St Mirren game, it was looking good. And I did have a little bit of outside hope that we could bring the gap down and put pressure on the Old Firm. But we fucked it right up. My fault. I'll fix it. We'll finish third this season. That's the focus. Get into Europe. Make ourselves best of the rest. And then next season, we'll go at the Old Firm. That's it, guys. I'll catch you in the next one. Till then, peace.